Turnlab is basically a music store. We're focusing on recording equipment, pro audio, and also electronic instruments, mainly synthesizers, drum machines. And we're also very known for our vintage gear. That is what put us on the map, basically. We try to deliver high quality, serviced vintage stuff. We sell everything fully serviced with warranty, and we also take in repairs. So we have a team of technicians, two guys that work for us, and then three freelance guys that sometimes work for us when they have the time. So yeah, that's often a tricky thing to do, to make sure the old gear keeps alive and is future-proof. Yeah, with the parts, it's often a challenge. You really have to go global on that. For some instruments, it's easy to get spare parts, instruments that are produced in high numbers. For others, it can be challenging. So you have to be lucky that somebody in, let's say, Japan opens a box and suddenly finds certain chips or whatever. You have to really know where to look, have the contacts, stuff like that, yeah. So a while ago we made like a proper shop, to say so, or at least like a room where people can come in and test certain things. We're not a typical shop where you walk in, but we work on appointments. We mainly sell online still, like I think 80% of our sales are online. But it's nice to have a place also for ourselves in the first place, like a nice room where we can put stuff up, play with it. Also, selling online is quite a challenge, especially with vintage gear, especially the bigger ones or the fragile ones. To ship them, it's often a whole operation for the logistics, especially if something has to ship to the other side of the world. In the beginning, I was really like sourcing gear myself. Now, later, since our network got bigger, we basically get offered a lot as well. We also have clients that buy something and then after, let's say, 2 years, they bring it back basically and they want something else. So it's a bit of an internal affair sometimes. But we do sometimes still look for stuff. But once you have a network that's so big, you basically always start looking within the network, or people have a collection that they don't use anymore and they want to sell it. We sell the whole collection, we service everything, so it all depends. We're sometimes connected with the other dealers, sometimes we email each other, like we have a client that's looking for something that someone else has, or vice versa, and we swap some stuff around or we help each other out. I don't believe in competition, I believe in working together, because especially with the vintage stuff, of course, it's sometimes things are so rare that there are only a few in the world for sale, and yeah, within the dealer network, we help each other out. I think the old stuff really still works, because it will always have its own character. Yeah, it's like a living machine. Well, most people that shop with us, they want a machine that they really feel and they want to experience that instrument. There are a lot of clones and remakes nowadays, but owning the original is still something that a lot of people like, and often they still also sound better, or they do certain quirky things sometimes that's nice to have in productions or is inspiring when making music. There isn't a lot of profit made anymore now these days. You really have to do it for love. Because if you want to do it well, you want to offer something that works, that's serviced, you sell it to a client that really is going to use it, it has to be as perfect as possible, then it's important that you put the effort into it to invest in it. which costs a lot of money. I have to pay my technicians, we have the parts. So often the margins aren't really high, but it's still something that we want to do and for the love of the machines. Besides the vintage stuff, we also sell new stuff. It's quite challenging these days because of a lot of big online stores and a lot of competition going on. But we try to focus a bit on brands that we like and that you might not find in a typical music store. Brands like Overstayer, Stem Audio, Soma, for example, which are boutique brands that are built by hand in small numbers. That we really like. It's a really interesting time for synths. There's a lot on the markets, a bit too much maybe sometime. It's really crowded also as a dealer. It's really hard to follow what's coming out. Brands, they bring something out or they announce something, but then it's not even on the market and they're already like throwing something new on social media or on online to tease people, so it's really crowded and really hard to follow. But it's an exciting time for an end user, and in the end, it's obviously made for people to use. So for a dealer, it might be exhausting and we might not earn much and we have to do a lot of follow-up. But as a user, it's a really interesting time, I think.